claims being made about President Trump and his family in a new book written by the president's own niece. NBC's Peter Alexander joins us now from the White House. Peter, good morning.
Hey, Craig, good morning to you. President Trump's estranged niece, Mary Trump, becomes the first family member to break ranks, speaking out about the president, her uncle, in this scathing book that the family did not want published. The White House this morning is pushing back about Ms. Trump's account, describing how the president cheated to get ahead and what his own sister thought about his candidacy. In her blistering new tell-all book, President Trump's niece, Mary Trump, a trained psychologist, slams her uncle as a narcissist who's unable to experience the entire spectrum of human emotion. Ms. Trump details a dysfunctional family led by a domineering father, Fred Trump Sr., who she writes was emotionally abusive and perverted his son's perception of the world and damaged his ability to live in it.
My dad, Fred Trump, was the smartest and hardest working man I ever knew.
On the night her father, Fred Trump Jr., died of an alcohol-induced heart attack, she claims the family sent him to the hospital alone while Donald Trump had gone to the movies. Why reveal family secrets? She writes, if President Trump is afforded a second term, it would be the end of American democracy. And goes further in describing her decision, she says, to provide some of the president's tax documents to the New York Times. Quote, I had to take Donald down. About the president's self-proclaimed brilliance.
I'm an extremely stable genius.
Yeah,
Ms. Trump, who's nearly 20 years younger than the president, claims her uncle enlisted a friend to take the SATs for him. Donald, who never lacked for funds, she writes, paid his buddy well, an allegation the White House calls completely false. Overnight, Alice Frankston, a friend of Mary Trump, authorized to speak on her behalf, explained why she wrote the book.
Mostly, she wants to get across that her uncle is really dangerous, and she has the unique perspective of having had a ringside seat to this family her whole life.
Ms. Trump says the president's sister, Mary Ann, a retired federal judge, mocked her brother's 2016 candidacy. He's a clown. Mary says Mary Ann, a devout Catholic, was furious that evangelicals backed her brother. Quoted as saying, the only time Donald went to church was when the cameras were there. It's mind-boggling. He has no principles. The White House blasts the book as fiction.
It's ridiculous, absurd allegations that have absolute no bearing in truth. Have yet to see the book, but it is a book of falsehoods.
In a little more detail, Mary Trump contested her grandfather's will and blamed the president and other relatives for her not getting a larger inheritance. President Trump and his brother say this book violates a non-disclosure agreement that Mrs. Trump signed nearly 20 years ago. And according to the White House, Ms. Trump wrote the book in her, quote, own financial self-interest. NBC News, by the way, has reached out to the president's sister, Mary Ann, but we did not get a response. Craig.
So the book making a lot of headlines this morning, Peter, also making headlines. Fallout of the president's decision to withdraw from the World Health Organization. What more can you tell us about that?
Yeah, that's right. This is significant. The U.S. sent a letter officially notifying the U.N. that it's leaving the World Health Organization next July, a move, obviously, that would take away one of the WHO's largest sources of funding during this global pandemic. The Trump administration has repeatedly criticized the WHO for being too slow, it says, to respond, and for being too lenient toward China. For his part, the former Vice President Joe Biden has responded, saying, if elected, he will reverse that decision on day one. Craig?
Peter Alexander from the White House. Peter, thank you.
All right. We do have a lot.